Welcome to Analysis Prime University. My name is Michael Quinn, and I am a senior analytics training consultant with Analysis Prime University. Creating a model is the next step in beginning to analyze your business data. That data file is going to contain all of your model's master and transactional data. Each column has a header, and these headers will be used to map each column of data to the correct dimension, measure, and/or attribute inside of your model. In this tutorial, you will learn how to create a model to organize and define relationships in your business data, and also how to import your data into your model. So within your tenant, you will want to select the app to create a model. You will select create new model, and we will choose new model. You will automatically have date and version created for you as defaults. What we're going to do is we're going to create measures for quantity sold and for price. If your view does not look like this, under the view icon, you can change it depending on which view you prefer to look at. Within the measure section, go ahead and select add a measure. And then in the measure details panel, we're going to create one for price. And we're going to have a decimal available to us. If you wanted to change the number of decimal places, you can. It can be anywhere from 1 to 7. And then I also want to create a measure for quantity sold. So I'm going to click on select another measure, and I will name it quantity sold. No spaces. And for this, I don't want a decimal, so I am going to select integer. I want to save these changes that I've made. And I'm going to name the model whatever makes sense for you. I'm going to save it into my files. This may take a moment, but I will then get a confirmation that the model has been saved. So now that I've created those measures, in the workspace, I'm going to go to Data Management and select Data Management. And then I want to import the data. I will select Import Data from that file that you have. For the purposes of this, we've got one that we've downloaded. I'm going to select source file and choose open, and then select import. Once this has finished, I can go ahead and set up the import. I would select set up import. And from this screen, you can see a brief overview, and you can see that there are no issues identified. So I will select next, and you can see my source columns, anything that's been unmapped or what has been mapped. So you can see the two items that we mapped for price and for quantity sold, and then select next. As you can see on the dimension properties view, there are no additional actions required. I will select next. And it's currently persisting all of our data changes, so this might take a couple of seconds for that to complete. Once it has been completed, you'll see that the data was successfully validated, and now you can select Run Import and finish running the import. So this may take, again, a couple of moments for the import to complete. Once the import has completed, you will see 5 check marks, and that means it has been successful, and you can start to utilize your business data as you wish. In this tutorial, we covered how to create a model to organize and define relationships in your business data, as well as how to import your data into your model. Thank you for watching. If you enjoyed this tutorial, click the like button below. You can also view our growing catalog of self-paced courses, tutorials, webinars, and join the community forum by creating your free account at analysisprimeuniversity.com.